As the region grows, so does its traffic volume. In turn, this increases pressure on our transportation systems. Slowly, neighborhoods have become relief valves for traffic congestion, with cut-through traffic commonly exceeding speed limits. One solution for this increasing problem has been the installation of traffic calming measures, such as speed humps. While traffic calming measures are effective at slowing traffic to some degree, speed humps pose a particular problem for emergency vehicles.
Oh, well, this is one of our main response routes here, and they have put in speed bumps over the last year or so, and this has significantly increased our response times. And unfortunately, this is during a time where there's sort of a renewed emphasis on decreasing our response times. You can see how I have to slow down to go over this bump. So it essentially becomes just a matter of hard acceleration with hard braking to basically get to where we want to go.
Tualatin Valley Fire and Rescue needs to get to neighborhood homes as fast as possible. However, speed humps cause an estimated time loss of about 9 seconds per hump. In some cases, this can mean the difference between life or life-altering consequences.
Oh, absolutely, seconds can count, and it can seem like longer to the person that we're responding to. You know, it may take us 30 seconds or 60 seconds longer to get to their residence or business to meet their needs, but it can seem like hours to them.
If, say, you're not breathing and your heart's not beating, every second is brain tissue. So the longer it takes us, the chances of survival drop.
The bottom line is some traffic calming measures can come with a price tag.
So the cost essentially is we've got to build fire stations closer together, or the citizens that are putting in the traffic calming devices as a trade-off, as a risk-benefit trade-off, have to accept slower response times.
Yet some calming measures have proven to be more firefighter-friendly. These include curb extensions, chokers, medians, pavement texture, street trees, and speed cushions. These types of measures do not slow emergency response significantly and can provide a winning solution for neighborhoods and emergency personnel. The key? Interagency partnerships that employ traffic calming measures while minimizing negative impacts on emergency response agencies.